Tonight, we are all getting together, the whole family, to celebrate Amber's 43rd birthday. Does mom look older?
No.
No, she looks the same. When you turn 50, I don't know.
I mean, we'll see it gradually, so maybe we won't see it.
Well, it depends on how hard you are on me.
True.
Are we waiting for the girls to get here?
Yeah.
And Jonah?
Yep.
I asked Anna and Elizabeth if they would stop by and pick up some dinner so mom doesn't have to cook.
Knock, knock.
Hello.
Yes?
First birthday, girl.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Are y'all the birthday surprise or the...
Yes, gift? And we actually need your two help to with food.
Trent, did you text Jonah?
Yes. Yeah, that was fun.
Well, do we want to go ahead and fix plates?
Yes. I've been messaging Jonah and texting, trying to figure out where he's at. No messages were answered, and it's frustrating. I just wanted everybody to be here. Jonah knew clearly what time to be home.
I can't see him on location.
Well, I can't either, so.
Half the time, his phone's dead.
Or asleep.
Or it's asleep, yeah, exactly.
When the event with Delta 8 and Jonah happened, I did not know what he took at that time. I just knew mom and dad were worried that we weren't able to find him.
He's our brother. Him going through something so traumatic like this, it's scary. We know kids and teenagers can be stupid and stuff, but like we never would have expected Jonah just to do something like this. And that was the biggest thing that like just kind of got to me and Anna was like, why would he want to do this?
He could have turned out way worse. And luckily it didn't. Thank God it didn't, but it could have turned out so much worse.
This is good, girls.
Very good. Very good.
Thank you.
Slaved over it all day.
Mm-hmm.
If that's the case, then tell us how you cooked it.
Yeah. Not this roast.
Pork chops.
Pork chops?
You know, roast, pork chops, same thing.
Same thing.
Let's hit the pause button real quick. What animal does this come from?
Oh, a pig.
What animal does the roast come from?
Oh, I know this one.
Oh, a rooster.
Can't make it up. In the South, we just say, bless your heart.
Yeah. Hi.
Who's late?
Sorry, I know I'm late, but I just completely lost track of time. Since the incident with Delta 8, work's not going well at all. I'm living with my friend, and that's going okay. Ashley and I have been dating a little over 3 years. Where me and Ashley are, it definitely could be better. All the situations, I think, could be better.
Is your phone dead?
No, my phone wasn't dead. I just haven't checked it.
Definitely concerned with Jonah showing up late and just kind of distant about it. The fact that, you know, he doesn't respond to text messages. And that's frequently. That's not just tonight.
Happy birthday. I can definitely tell my dad is very annoyed right now. My mom is definitely hiding it, but she's also annoyed as well. I could just tell the vibe is a little off.
What'd you do today, Jonah?
Went to work, and then just about it. Came home and chilled. I had a mind that it was mom's birthday. I just lost track of time.
I was texting you nonstop.
You must be the only 22-year-old never to check your phone. Why aren't you checking your phone?
I know it's not normal for people my age, but you know, I just don't have a big enough priority like I should do, check my phone.
I'm not gonna fuss about it.
It's mom's birthday.
Y'all wanna do some cake and ice cream now?
That's fine.
The fact that I was late hurt my mom's feelings, but I know it affected my dad a lot more because he expected me to show up on time.
43.
It's always great to have all of the kids home and all of us around the same table.
Given the circumstances right now where we're at with Jonah and his understanding mom, it was still good to see Jonah.
Do you need this to go in the fridge?
No, before they all come back in here. There are some things, and sometimes you have to make priorities. You knew what we had going on. You knew what time to be here.
Right.
There's distractions or something going on. We got to get it figured out. Right now, we don't really have an idea of what's going on with Jonah. He's 22 years old. He does not live in our home. But we still have a right to be concerned. You and I are just gonna have to have a sit down. Oh, we ain't gonna do it tonight at the birthday party. We let all the big kids live their independent lives and do things. But when we see things that are not healthy and are not good, we step in. I'll do this, go in there and hang out with mom and them, and I'll get this stuff. It's gonna take some time. We gotta figure out what's going on. There are some problems.
Hi.
Hey.
Saw your text and said you wanted to meet.
Yes.
Where's your phone?
In my pocket.
Well, I mean, one of the big concerns we have is the fact that you're still not on the family locator. And after the Delta 8 incident, mom and dad have a lot of, I don't know if we want to call it PTSD, if we want
That's
to call it.
That's basically what it is.
That situation, I mean, it went bad enough, but it could have been really bad.
Right.
I told you when that incident happened, I told you, we're going to get through this. And when we're going to get through this, which way are we going to move?
Forward.
We're not going to sit still. We're not going to fall back. We're going to move forward, and we're going to move forward together as a family, right?
Yep.
But if we're not in the know, and if we don't know what's going on to help you right now, it hurts us, buddy.
No.
We know there is something going on. Is it work? Is it, are we still into things, into, you know, whether it's drinking, whether it's other forms of...
Yeah, no, I mean, all that's cut out. It's a mixture of all of things that are causing almost extreme anxiety. And I don't think I realized it until after the incident in my life. I definitely have experienced critical anxiety, maybe some forms of depression. I've just never found a way to deal with it.
Looking back, even you as like a 3, 2, 3, 4-year-old, anxiety has definitely been something that has been a part of your life. It was one of these things that we thought, he'll grow out of it.
Well, that's what I
he'll
thought.
He'll get better.
I just taught to practice myself in just either ignoring it, going to bed.
You were sleeping.
Yeah.
All the time.
I wanted to get sleeping would make the time go by faster.
When Jonah comes to us and tells us that he hasn't been working his regular schedule at work and he hasn't been doing his part, that's when Amber and I knew that there was more to the problem than just this episode with Delta 8.
If you're not going to work on a regular basis, you're not making money. And I'm just going to make the executive decision that we're not doing this anymore and that you need to come home. We will pack you up, bring you home, and we need to get to the root of the problem.
Jonah moving back home with mom and dad is a matter of we're going to help him. And not only is Jonah going to learn how to live with anxiety and some of the struggles that he's has going on, we're going to learn as well.
We can definitely look at it that, you know, it sucks and why is it like this and what are people going to think because I'm having to move back home. Or we can look at this at like, look, I'm looking to have a better life. So now is the best time to figure this out.
There's really no telling whether or not this is actually going to help. It was enjoyable to move away and, take on life, you know, completely on my own. So now moving back, it's going to suck.
We will start setting up appointments and get things in order to start making progress.
3 weeks from now, I would like to be at your house and we're packing up.
He's raising his hand for help, and that's the first step towards changing. So we need to be there to support him and get him the help that he needs.